basically stand and turn towards the back of the church. Let's begin in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you all. As the other day in the church, we recall that some years ago, cantered into the halls of Christ through the waters of baptism, so now we sprinkle this cup with holy water, recalling us who do the words of St. Paul in his letter to the Romans. Are you not aware that we who are baptized into Christ are baptized into, who were baptized into Christ Jesus? In the waters of baptism, and died with Christ, and rose with a new life, we now share eternal belonging with him. The day of Kent's baptism, the following prayer was said, become a new creation, clothe yourself with Christ, see him this white garment. We call that day as the family places the white pall on the coffin. I invite you to join in opening song number 383. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith possesses that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mercy, your servant Kent, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Let us be seated as we listen to the Word of God.
Time to be born and a time to die. Time to plant and time to uproot the plant. Time to weep and time to laugh. And time to mourn. Time to dance. Time to scatter stones and time to gather them. Time to embrace and time to be far from embraces. Time to seek and time to lose. Time to keep and time to cast away. Time to rend and time to sow. And time to be silent. Time to speak. What advantage has the worker from his toil? I've considered the task which God has appointed for men to be busy about. He has made everything appropriate to its time. And has put the timeless into their hearts without man's ever discovering from beginning to end the work which God has done. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to Timothy. Remember Jesus Christ, raised from the dead, a descendant of David, such is my gospel, for which I am suffering, even to the point of chains, like a criminal. But the word of God is not chained. Therefore, I bear with everything for the sake of those who are chosen, so that they too may obtain the salvation that is in Jesus Christ, together with eternal glory. This saying is trustworthy. If we have died with him, we shall also live with him. If we persevere, we shall also reign with him. But if we deny him, he will deny us. If we are unfaithful, he remains unfaithful, for he cannot deny himself. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
am the living bread that came down from heaven, says the Lord. Whoever eats this bread will live forever.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, Father, my disciples are your gift to me, and I wish that where I am they also may be with me, that they may see my glory that you gave me, because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world does not know you, but I know you, and they know that you sent me. I made known to them your name, and I will make it known, that the love with which you love me may be in them, and I in them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I want you to be seated. Gathered today with heavy hearts. October 31st, 2021, Kent Meidinger, husband to Colette, father to son Mackenzie, and daughter Cal, entered into eternal life. And so we gather today to celebrate his life. Hearts, as I said, heavy with grief. Yet we gather as a community of believers who believe that life does not end with death. After graduating from college, Kent worked with his father in the body shop here in town for some years, taking over the business in 97. Edgeley Collision Center, or Auto Collision Center, was of course his place of business, as you all know. His second passion was restoring cars, other things. The obituary says he was a great man, would help anyone with anything. And his stubbornness led him to be wholeheartedly good habit to have. As you know, I've pulled that quote from the obituary. Kent's profession, bought a body, no dog, and restored, rebuilt, redid a number of different things throughout his lifetime, throughout the years. It's kind of odd that as people we have this ability to restore things to new again. Unfortunately, we cannot always do this with people, cannot rebuild human flesh. Yes, many are healed and restored to health, but we know it's only temporary, not all. Kent, unfortunate in this sense. We all recognize at the same time that we all shall pass from this earth. In essence, then, when we meet our Lord, we shall be restored again, made new in Christ Jesus, and that process has begun for Kent. That's a great, fabulous. Last Sunday evening, I was called by the hospice nurse to come home to my neighbor home. Kent was struggling to breathe, let alone just get comfortable. His struggles, his heavy breathing were quite obvious. But I witnessed something that I was very impressed with. The entire family was around his bed. A family who, by their actions, obviously cared deeply for this humble person struggling to just breathe. His wife, his son, his daughter, sibling, all around the bed, doing whatever they could to help him in any manner, shape, or form. Although everything we do is mutual in one sense, but that doesn't mean we don't cry. I mention this because this doesn't always happen with people. I'm not making light of other people by any means. We struggle with death, especially when that's someone very close to us. The pain is too great. Many people would rather flee. Our first reading from the book of Ecclesiastes is quite often used for funerals. All things, time for all things under the sun. It's very brief, to the point, very poignant. Death is one of those times, though. One that we wish would not come. Hard as we can try, we cannot turn it into non-existence. Reality is, we know otherwise. And Christ himself, the very Son of God, also experienced pain, suffering, and death. Our second reading today from Timothy, St. Paul speaks of the suffering that he himself endured for Christ. He said, even to the point of chains, like a criminal. I'm guessing Kent kind of felt like that evening. Probably wouldn't have spoken it that way, but it probably was close. Death treats us all as if we are criminals. Paul says, however, the word of God is not chained. It can't free from death. And to quote Paul, so that the sake of those who are chosen may obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus together with eternal glory. We have also saw in the obituary that Kent's last words were never give up. And this is exactly what St. Paul is referring to. Death may seemingly have the last answer, but it doesn't. Christ has chosen us as his brothers and sisters. So Paul is calling us to never give up. There's more to come. May not always happen in this life, but in the life that Christ calls us to, never give up. St. Paul says, if we persevere, we shall also reign with him. Those words of Kent again, never give up, apply very well to what Paul is speaking about. There's, of course, a reason as God's children that we're all called to never give up. We hear and see this in the Gospel of John. Of course, of Jesus' confidence to never give up. He prays for not only his disciples, but for us here today. Christ says, I will that they be with me. Kind of a strange petition, closer to a demand than a request. And your children willed that you fed them supper. You might wonder what they were talking about. Suggests that's not how they asked for things. And nowhere in the scriptures do we find God's people praying that way. We're taught to make our requests to God with humility and reverence in a form of petition, not a demand. Well, when it comes to Christ, the very Son of God, it's quite appropriate then, he put it this way, as he prayed not only for his disciples, for us here today as well, for Kent as well. The unchanging, eternal Word of God who took on flesh became human so that we too might receive eternal life. Jesus is expressing the very heart and mind of God, the will of God, which cannot be changed. All that the Father has given to Christ will come to him and will be with him in glory eternal, and that all includes each of us. And so, yes, never give up. Kent, may you rest forever in the peace of Christ. I invite you to stand for the prayers of the faithful. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we now join our prayers to his. in baptism can't receive the light of Christ, scatter the darkness now, and lead him over the waters of death, we pray to the Lord. Our brother was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord. Many friends and members of our own families have gone before us and await the coming kingdom of God. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord. Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord. Family and friends of Kent who seek comfort and consolation, Lord, heal their pain, dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. We pray to the Lord. We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother. Strengthen our hopes that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. We pray to the Lord. Lord God, give her peace and heal her souls. Hear the prayers of your neighbor, Jesus Christ. The voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. All this we ask through Christ our Lord. Would you be seated for the preparation of the altar? Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we receive the bread we offer you. Go to the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness we receive the wine, we offer you fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Let's stand, pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Kent, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
Amen.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for you, faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Thank you.
invite you to kneel and be seated as is the practice of your parish. Lord, be holy, O Lord, and I'm created right to give you praise for, through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, for the power and working of the Holy Spirit to give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts that we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and giving you thanks. He said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church in recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with this Holy Spirit we become one body, one spirit in Christ. He make of us an eternal offering to you, so that what we may obtain, that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints in whose constant intercession in your presence you rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of reconciliation and prayer, Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope John, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you summoned before you today in your compassion and merciful Father. Gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Command the form of God. divine teachings, I invite you to stand as we dare to pray, Our Father. We pray from evil, graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Go down to the family first with the dominion and then come to the right side.
Please join in singing the communion hymn number 432.
Just be the one.
pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body and blood, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by our mother can't we come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother and may not very well express our affection for him. May ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Please join me in singing the song of farewell, number 675, verses 1, 2, 4.
Him is number 663. Precious Lord, take my hand.